Could the most dangerous appliance in your home be your table lamp? If you're using CFL bulbs, you might be letting something more than light into your life. The hugely popular CFL bulb, with its signature corkscrew design, was invented in 1976. Prohibitively expensive at first, the compact fluorescent light didn't enter the mainstream until the early 2000s. A drop in price and legislation such as 2007's Energy Independence and Security Act phasing out traditional bulbs boosted their popularity, as did the compact fluorescent's early reputation as an energy saver. So, what's not to like? For one, CFL standing as an energy-efficient option is overstated, as noted by All Electric Services. Plus, as technology continues to advance, better options than CFL bulbs are hitting the market. Although fluorescents have surpassed conventional incandescent bulbs as a lighting choice by consumers, according to VeraBright, they are being left in the proverbial dust by LED light bulbs in terms of color, energy consumption, safety potential, and price. What's more, old-fashioned CFL bulbs have a host of potential hazards that will convince you to ditch them forever. CFL bulbs have been proven to emit potentially harmful ultraviolet radiation. A 2012 Stony Brook University study concluded that the radiation from the bulbs was sufficient to cause symptoms ranging from dizziness to eye strain. Even cataracts and macular degeneration may be connected. The Stony Brook study also concluded that the UVA and the UVC rays emitted by the CFL bulbs can be harmful to the skin, and lifelong exposure could eventually cause cancer. Research conducted by the European Environment Agency reached a similar conclusion. CFL bulbs, particularly aging ones, also have a tendency to flicker. Turbo Future describes a possible link between this flaw and an aggravation of symptoms for those with migraines, lupus, inner ear disease, and light-sensitive epilepsy. In light of these concerns, CFL bulbs are not appropriate for up-close use, should be enclosed in glass, and the lamp should be closed at the bottom. Energy Star reports that a typical CFL bulb contains 4 milligrams of mercury, an element famously toxic to humans and animals. According to the EPA, manufacturers are working to lower the level of mercury in CFLs, but can't remove it entirely, as the bulb's efficiency depends on the neurotoxin. So long as the bulb is intact, mercury exposure is not a concern. However, mercury vapor is immediately released when the bulb breaks, and mercury powder can also escape if the bulb is compromised. Careless or improper disposal of CFL bulbs increases the chance of mercury contamination. Disposal of the compact lights is regulated, and they must be discarded in a hazardous waste facility. They cannot simply be recycled for fear of contaminating other recyclables. This complex disposal process adds to the cost of CFLs.
1/20th of a teaspoon of mercury can contaminate 25 acres of water. That's why we're trying to educate people to recycle the bulbs.
Some consider the light produced by CFL bulbs to be harsh, as is often the case with other fluorescents. The cumulative process of switching them on and off diminishes their lifespan and reduces their efficiency too. This makes the compact bulbs unsuitable, for example, for bathroom use, per ProCal Lighting. CFL lights also need several seconds to warm up and reach full brightness. According to How Stuff Works, they may even require more than 15 minutes to reach full brightness after being turned on, whereas LED lights go to full brightness immediately. The color of the bulbs may also waver over time. Finally, even though they emit less heat than incandescent bulbs, CFLs still lose 80% of their energy as heat, as noted by the U.S. Department of Energy. An additional flaw of the compact bulbs is that their performance is affected by extreme temperature conditions. Cold weather results in dimmer light. CFL use outdoors is therefore limited, unless the bulbs are shielded from the elements. The small fluorescents are also not recommended to be housed in closed fixtures. They get too hot in recessed lighting. Looking for a dimmable bulb? Forget using a CFL. They can't be dimmed smoothly due to their sluggish startup and warm-up times. Garden Guides also warns that CFL bulbs will not fit in all fixtures. The cost of replacing them with appropriately sized alternatives might negate any potential savings.